नमस्कार सलाम याली मदद सत श्री अकाल गुड मॉर्निंग टू कैलगरी आप सबका स्वागत है हमारे प्रोग्राम आपकी आवाज में। ये प्रोग्राम आप देखते हैं हमारे अपने फेवरेट टीवी चैनल पंजाबी नेशनल पर और सुनते हैं हमारे अपने फेवरेट रेडियो चैनल रेडियो सुरसंगम पर। मैं आपका होस्ट आपका दोस्त अपने प्राण आपका स्वागत करता हूँ और आशा करता हूँ आपका लास्ट वीक बहुत बढ़िया गया होगा, खुशियों से भरा गया होगा, सेहत से भरा गया होगा। बजट 2022 आ चुका है और लोगों के हिसाब से काफ़ी प्रॉमिसिंग लग रहा है, बट स्टिल बहुत सारी चीज़ें क्लियर होनी ज़रूरी है, तो इसलिए हम लोग कोशिश करते हैं कि आप तक सही मैसेजेस पहुँचाए जाएं। और कोई भी गवर्नमेंट हो लेकिन हमारा मीडिया ग्रुप पंजाबी नेशनल को हमेशा एक भरोसेमंद मीडिया ग्रुप माना जा गया है और माना जाता है पूरे कैनेडा में, और इसलिए ये अपॉर्चुनिटीज हमें दी जाती हैं ताकि हम उनका मैसेज नुमाइंदों का, गवर्नमेंट के नुमाइंदों का आप तक पहुंचा सकें। इसी तर्ज पर पिछले कुछ दिनों से हम लोग डिफरेंट मिनिस्टर्स ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर्स से बात कर रहे थे और उनके मैसेजेस आप तक लेके आ रहे थे, और आज हमारे साथ जुड़ी हैं एसोसिएट मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेटस ऑफ वुमेन मिस विटनी आइज़क, जो ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर हैं स्टेटस ऑफ वुमेन की अल्बर्टा की। आइए उनसे बातचीत करते हैं और जानते हैं कि इस बार 2022 का जो बजट है वो उनके पोर्टफोलियो में क्या नई चीजें लेके आया है और क्या बेनिफिट लोगों को मिलने वाले हैं। आइए मिलकर स्वागत करते हैं हमारे अपने ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर का, मिनिस्टर विटनी आइज़क। मैम, इफ यू डोंट माइंड, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई हैव फॉर यू इज इफ यू कैन एक्सप्लेन, एंड बिकॉज देयर आर सर्टेन पीपल और मे बी a lot of people who will not know exactly what is your portfolio and what exactly you take care of in government right now, please.
You bet. So in the Ministry for the Status of Women, we work on all issues that have to do with the equality of women in society. We work on issues to better the lives of everyday women in very, very real ways, including working towards employment inclusion, as well as upskilling, reskilling, a lot of work on gender-based violence. And we're really pleased to be able to also welcome to our ministry a Parliamentary Secretary for Elder Women Issues. Parliamentary Secretary Jackie Lovely will be working on issues specifically around the quality of life for elder women. And we're doing some incredible work right now with women in our recovery plan, actually.
Now that's an amazing portfolio, and being a woman, you must be feeling that in certain societies, rather I can say this society also, even all over the world, the equality of women is very much needed. And I'm very proud to say that we also have a small non-profit where we raise this voice all the time that equality of women is very much needed and we should stop or at least try to send this message as much as possible to make any kind of violence or any degraded things which are said or done with women. And I think you're doing an amazing job. Thank you for that, ma'am.
Thanks, Amrit. You know, and it's really important to recognize that women are really the backbone of our economy. You know, the more that women are involved in fulfilling, well-paying careers, the better off our economy will be, better off our communities will be, and the better off our families will be.
Absolutely, ma'am. So to start with this 2022 budget, people are saying looks promising, and people are taking it in a positive way because we are coming out of pandemic, and things are looking a little bit clearer, but again, we still have to be, we should take precautions and be very careful moving forward. So on the portfolio, what are the new things which we'll be seeing in during this budget or this coming year now?
Well, my portfolio, my ministry works actually cross ministry with many, many ministries, including jobs, economy and innovation, post-secondary or advanced education, children's services. You know, some of the most important things that will affect women are, for instance, our new childcare deal. Minister Schultz worked very, very hard on that deal to create a Made in Alberta childcare plan that will drop the fees for daycare for most families by about 50%. That's huge for women. That's a huge investment. Yeah.
Yes.
Additionally, we're spending $600 million, I think it's $600 million on increasing employment opportunities. This will look very much like, for instance, $175 million going to post-secondary institutions to create 7,000 new spaces across Alberta so that people can reskill, upskill, go to university, college, and have really fulfilling careers in focused areas where we need workers. Alberta is actually having a bit of a labor shortage. So we're looking very forward to seeing our employment numbers going up, especially as tourism starts to get going again. I think we have a great future ahead of us.
Definitely, ma'am. And especially if you talk about neighboring areas of Calgary, they are world known and tourism will definitely start and things are looking promising. And as you are saying, creating more job opportunities and creating more number of seats in post-secondary education institutes is a very big thing because that will create at least, you know, some curiosity, some zeal in people so that they can study in their own respective cities, not go outside and spend more money.
Right. You know, being able to study at home is so critical. Not having to have students go across the country, but be able to study in Alberta is actually really critical. And I'll tell you, Amrit, the other piece around this is we need to make sure that we have more women joining in the STEM field. So that's science, technology, engineering, and math. That is a pipeline that needs to be full of women. And so we in our ministry have been working hard on that. We actually have a scholarship for women in STEM. It's just closed and we'll be awarding it shortly. And I'm very pleased about that. But some of the spaces that we'll be opening up in these post-secondary institutions will be for the STEM fields and for women to join the STEM fields. Recently also just announced $1.9 million for Momentum to reskill and upskill women into the high tech field. So, you know, we're doing some really on the ground helpful things to make sure that we have those high tech and STEM workers into the future.
That's amazing, ma'am. And STEM scholarship is a very big, project, and a lot of people will get benefit from it. That's what I believe. The one request I would like to say over here or make is if you can, you know, have a ground level seminars in different languages so that the message reaches those women who are, you know, not so computer savvy and they don't know exactly, you know, how to read or to look for this information on the internet. Even if we have, you know, a couple of seminars every month with different organizations and in their respective languages, whether it's Chinese or Urdu or Hindi or Punjabi, at least that message will reach them and they'll be able to get information on this amazing program.
You bet. And, you know, one of the great lessons out of the pandemic has been we've learned that we actually have great ability to provide translated services. It really is so important in our communities. And so we will be reaching out, working with many different community groups. We'll have some announcements on that shortly. And we'll also be making sure that women have easy access to information in one spot. And another announcement will be coming out shortly as well.
That's amazing. Another the scholarship is person's case sponsorship. What is that exactly?
So the person's case was a case where, women were not allowed to sit in the Senate. They weren't allowed to be senators. Mm-hmm. And so the women that we refer to as the famous five who came from Calgary actually took a case to court, to the Supreme Court, to have women deemed as persons. The reason they couldn't be senators was because legally they weren't deemed to be persons. And so they went to the Supreme Court. The court case unfortunately failed. They ended up going to the Privy Council in England to get the ruling. They got the ruling. Women became persons, and we celebrate that today. And so the Persons Case Scholarship is really about ensuring that folks have money to study in areas where in the arts, where they will be studying anything that has to do with equality and promoting equality and inclusion. So it's a really great way to celebrate a fantastic undertaking by five amazing women from right here in Calgary.
That's amazing. And that information, if somebody wants to get the scholarship, is available on calgary.alberta.ca.
Yes. Yeah, you bet.
Great. Another request which is there from the community, I can see, because I work very closely with, especially with elderly people and seniors. We need to have more and more programs to have more knowledge and more information about domestic violence. Domestic violence against women is, people have, you know, they organize a lot of things, but they never come up with solutions. They will just say that, okay, you can do this, you can do that, but people are not working enough to curb the rate which is going up, and people are not actually giving the solutions. Because in South Asian community, the most important factor is that people are very afraid of coming out because of their own beliefs. Maybe it is religious, maybe they don't want to go against the family if it is within the family. So please, it is our request, as we have met first time and I was looking forward for a meeting, you know, with you or with such portfolio where I can request with folded hands that please have more solutions for these problems so that, you know, these things can be stopped.
You know, Amrit, you bring up a really good point. A lot of family violence is kept behind closed doors. It's not reported. And when it's not reported, families can't get help. And one of the biggest solutions for family violence is actually changing the culture that leads to it, whereby we need women to be able to talk to other women. We need members of our community to talk to each other, to talk openly about it, to have these conversations so that people understand. Not only is family violence and gender-based violence completely wrong, it's harmful, it's hurtful, it breaks down the family, it ends up breaking down the community, and we really can do more in terms of changing the culture. And there's a lot of really fantastic organizations out there that are working on these issues, and we're going to continue to work with them, we're going to continue to fund them to make sure that everybody has an opportunity to learn and to also promote healthy family culture. And I think it's, I think we're entering a new era where we are actually going to deal with the causes of family violence as opposed to just dealing with the symptoms on the other side of it. And so for anybody who's suffering, we have wonderful services that are available in Alberta. You can start by calling 211. It's a fantastic way to find information and to get help. So I'm glad you brought that up, Amrit.
And I wanted you to say it because what happens is that, you know, people say anybody can say anything. But if the minister is saying, honorable minister is saying, it means a lot. So thank you for that assurance. And thank you for being there for all the women who need this help and giving out that information. I'm very sure that people will change and women will come out in case they are suffering from this dilemma, and they will speak out and they will at least share the information where they can get help. Thank you for that, ma'am. So moving forward, the last question for today will be, any other information you want to share about this budget and your portfolio which will be coming and we'll be seeing in coming year?
Well, I'll tell you, this budget is important to all Albertans. It's important to women. Part of the reason it's important is because we have made sure that our spending trajectory has flattened out. You know, previously, the previous government had us on a spending trajectory of about 4 to 4.5% per year. Imagine if I came to you and said, hey, I'd like to take 4% of your income this year. And then next year I say, oh, I'd like to take 4% more. And then the next year, this 4% more. That's not sustainable. And as such, this new spending trajectory, we've managed to fund everything. We've been surgical with our efficiencies. We've been very careful with how we've flattened our curve. But it really is important to recognize that by doing this, we're allowing our economy to grow. We are providing opportunity because of this. This will be less money taken out to pay back debt. And the really good news is this is going to be great for our children and grandchildren because there will be less debt to pay off at the end of the day. So really pleased with this budget. Great opportunities, increased spending in health, $600 million. We're going to get some of our wait lists down. That's so important to people right now. We're going to continue to make sure that we've got a contingency there for the pandemic in case we ever need it. We're going to make sure that we've got great money in education, funding some of our charter and collegiates, as well as making sure that children have a fantastic education. We know how important that is. And as I mentioned before, we have $600 million in our jobs money. So
that's amazing. Thank you so much for that amazing news, ma'am. And we look forward to the things happening in a right way, in a proper way, in positive way in coming time. Thank you for your time today, and we'll see you soon again, ma'am.
Pleasure being with you. Thanks.
Thank you. Take care, ma'am. So ye the hamari Associate Minister of Status of Women, विटनी आइज़क, जिन्होंने हमें बताया कि कुछ नए प्रोग्राम्स आ रहे हैं जो कि है रादर हैं उनका फ़ायदा ले सकते हैं, और पैसा उसमें दिया गया है. स्टेम स्कॉलरशिप है, के पर्सन्स केस स्कॉलरशिप है, और स्पेशली वुमेन के लिए बहुत कुछ इस बजट में है. 50% आपका जो चाइल्ड केयर फी है वो कम हो जाएगी. बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें जिसकी आप इंफॉर्मेशन दे सकते हैं alberta.ca में. मैं आपसे इजाजत लेता हूं और कुछ नई इंफॉर्मेशन के साथ, कुछ नए मैसेजेस के साथ दोबारा आपसे जुड़ूंगा. सिर्फ ये कहना चाहूंगा कि हर टीवी शो का मतलब सिर्फ ब्रेकिंग न्यूज नहीं, बहस नहीं, हंगामा नहीं, तमाशा नहीं. ये टीवी शो है आपकी आवाज का, आपके मुद्दे का, आपके जज्बात के साथ साथ आपके भरोसे का, और आपका भरोसा हमारी जिम्मेदारी है. उम्मीद आपकी, कोशिश हमारी है. Thank you.